CBN Chief Political Analyst David Brody's joining us right today. David, a few days ago, you described this legal strategy as a Hail Mary pass. Do you think they've got any chance of scoring with it?
Pat, it's in the Hail Mary stage for sure. I mean, look, the president has a political PR problem, and that is we see fireworks saying 46 with Biden going up in the air, and the media has crowned him the new president of the United States, president-elect, and so many congratulation calls are coming in. So there's clearly a political PR problem for the president, but I do feel like I'm living in two polar opposite universes here. I mean, you've got that whole media coronation of Joe Biden, and then all of a sudden, on the other side, you've got, well, wait a minute. The last time I checked, the president has not conceded that there is a legal fight going on. And, you know, I was doing some research over the weekend, and as I looked, I came across some video of Al Gore speaking just days after the election in 2000, that Bush v. Gore we know all about. He said at the time, we must count every vote, and once we count every vote, then we can move on in this country and we'll have a new president, or we'll have a president of the United States at that point. So once again, he kept saying count every vote. That is exactly what Donald Trump is doing, and it is journalistic malpractice for the journalists across this country to declare not only Joe Biden the winner as president-elect, you can do that, that's kind of a tradition what we've done, but for them to run with this narrative of like it's a fait accompli, it's all over, and they are ignoring, and let's be honest, Pat, they are ignoring this whole other side, this other polar opposite universe that Trump folks want to talk about. But they did not ignore that polar opposite universe in 2000 when Al Gore said the exact same thing that Donald Trump has been saying. Pat, journalism is dead in America.
Well, I'll buy that in. What do you think Joe Biden will do first when, if he is confirmed?
There's so many different things. I mean, get ready for a federal mask mandate. What does that look like exactly? Yes, I understand that states have to decide about masks and counties and all of that. But there's going to be a push by a President Joe Biden, if that ends up becoming the case, for some sort of federal mask mandate pushed by the CDC and Anthony Fauci. That's number one. He's going to rejoin the World Health Organization. The United States will. They'll rejoin the Paris Climate Accord. The fracking will no fracking on federal lands. I can go on and on. Transgender rights for kids in terms of bathroom use and all that, that'll be re-implemented. I mean, I can go on and on. We'll see about the packing of the court. If it goes south in Georgia for Republicans, in other words, if Democrats win back the Senate, get ready for court packing. Joe Biden might not be a fan of it, but, you know, let me think. So what? Because at this point, Democrats are going to feel emboldened, even though we know that this election was anything but a mandate. It's funny, you hear Nancy Pelosi talking about a mandate. What mandate exactly? Anyhow, the whole thing's kind of bizarre to me, Pat.
Some thought that Nancy Pelosi can't get a majority vote in the House to become Speaker. She may lose her seat because of the seats that have been lost. It really surprised the Democrats that they lost so many seats in the House.
Well, 100%. It's funny to hear Nancy Pelosi talk about a mandate, because if there's a mandate, she may not be part of it. You know, there is a sense inside Capitol Hill that they're looking for a replacement for Nancy Pelosi, and that she was part of the reason, a big part of the reason, why Republicans did actually so well. So, look, there's a lot of reckoning to be had. And, you know, it's interesting. A lot of people really haven't thought this through, which is, wait a minute, Republicans actually did pretty well in the House, and they didn't have that blowout that a lot of people were thinking Democrats were going to have in the Senate. So Republicans did really well, except for the most popular Republican, Donald Trump. That's where a lot of folks wonder, wait, what in the world is going on here? And I got to tell you, I think we have an electoral as the world turns coming up. I think this is like an electora telenovela, and I think we're still in the process of it all.
Well, we'll stay tuned for Act Two. But when you think of the extreme things, I imagine the electorate, I mean, if they defund the police, if the rioting continues, if there's no law and order, if the taxes are being raised, if people lose their jobs because the fossil fuels are out, and if there's a demonization of the Trump supporters, which is, you remember Hillary Clinton called them a basket of deplorables. Well, they're calling these people other names, and How can we have unity when they insult the people who oppose you? And there's some thought the AOC crowd is saying to take away any privilege that any Trump supporter had. It's insanity.
Well, that's right. And remember, Joe Biden, just in the last couple of weeks before at the end of the campaign, called all of Trump's supporters chumps. And so it's kind of interesting to see Joe Biden saying it's time to heal the nation. Well, you know, the way Trump supporters see it, you try to impeach the guy, or actually you ended up impeaching the guy. You've been trying to get this guy from day one. You've been demeaning and demoralizing Trump supporters left and right. And now all of a sudden you want them to just say, you know what, that's okay, we're fine with it. No, look, I think this is, we're heading down a very dangerous path in this country. And then Donald Trump doing rallies, and you know that's coming. I've talked to two Trump campaign sources this morning that can confirm what Axios is reporting this morning, which is that Donald Trump will be doing campaign rallies. Look, this has a powder keg on it, Pat. And one thing I can tell you, look, if we think this is how it ends with a president-elect Joe Biden right now, then we haven't been paying attention for the last 4 years. Do you think Donald Trump is just going to let this go? Look, Pat, something's coming around the bend. Let's wait and see what it is.
Well, it's frightening because this country could explode, and that's the thing that we all fear. And when we do, you see, you've got a president-elect of one party. You have the sitting president of another party. They're fighting each other like cats and dogs. There's rioting out in the streets. And all of a sudden, Erdogan or somebody like that will say, this is our chance to move against Israel. And suddenly, you've got another war. And if the Chinese make a move in the South China Sea, it's devastating. I mean, but who's going to stop them? If the Chinese move up and start taking those islands and saying, this is our territory, who's going to go after them? And David, I understand the Secretary of Defense said he was going to resign. He's still in. But who's running the Pentagon?
Well, you're absolutely right, Pat. And here's part of the problem. It kind of goes to a broader issue. There's a Trump appointee, you know, the General Service Administration, the GSA, allows federal money to be appointed, as you know, Pat, for a transition from Trump to Biden. Well, the GSA is not doing any of that. They're not giving any money over yet to the Biden folks to have some sort of transition process. So there is a financial limbo, not to mention electoral limbo here until results are certified. So we are in this this strange period of let's just wait, even though if you look at the media and you see fireworks going off in the sky, you'd never think.